All right, in this one, we are going to see what is extern C in C. Except, no, it's not C, it's C++. But you often see it when you explore header files in C. So, might as well explain why it's there. And so, the reason you would want to use this is because by default, your C header files or your C libraries are not compatible with C++. And so you would like to make them compatible. So here in my example, you can see that I have a very simple t.c, t.h, so that will be my library. And I have a main.c that wants to use those features from those other files. And I want to compile this library, so the add function with a C compiler. And I want to reuse the object file I got in my main.c, but I want to compile my main with a C++ compiler. And so to explain that, let's see. So I compile my library with a C compiler, so GCC. Then I try to do G++, where I try to compile main.c, but with T.o, that was compiled with another, like with a C compiler. And you can see there is an error because there is an undefined reference to add, but add is present in the t.o. And to show that, we can use the nm utilities, which by default lists symbols in a file. So if we list the symbols in t.o, we see that add is present. So that's a bit strange. Now let's compile t.c, but with a C++ compiler and see what it expects as a symbol. So it's, yeah. Same thing, but we compiled it with the C++ compiler. Now we look at the symbol and oh, what the hell is this? And so C++ for multiple complex reasons, for example, method function overloading operator, yeah, function overloading, like you can have a function that you could like redefine this function to take floats as arguments and so on and so on. I won't go over all the specifics in C++, but it has various advanced features like this that require some kind of convention when it comes to function names that is a bit more complicated than the one that we have in C. And so, but we would still like our stuff that is compiled with a regular C compiler to be compatible with C++, and that's where this extern C comes in. So if we so it's not in the t.c file, so the t.c file can still be compiled with a regular C compiler that doesn't change at all. It's just in the header file where the function is defined that will be imported in the main in the main that we compile with C++. We're gonna do extern and then a C string like so. It's a bit of a strange syntax, but that's how you do it. And now if we compile with a C++ compiler or main and our object file, you can see that it works. And yeah, the t.o still has the regular add symbol, no, nothing C++ related. Of course, the downside of this is that you would like to make your header file compatible with C and C++, because now if we try to compile all this with a C compiler instead of a C++ compiler, we can see that the extern C syntax does not exist in C. It only exists in C++. So you want both. And what you usually see then is if def, and then there is this macro that is defined by C++ compiler or at least G++, where it defines underscore underscore C++ if it's a C++ compiler looking at the header file, otherwise it's not defined. And so here, if it's a C compiler, it will just see this. If it's a C++ compiler, it will see this. Let's compile this now, and we can see that it works with a C compiler, and it runs. It works with a C++ compiler, and it runs. And yeah, that's it. That's how you make your C libraries compatible with C++. Again, strange syntax to put like a C string like that and reuse the extern keyword. But oh well, C++ is a bit weird already, so Why not a bit more? And so, so yeah, that's it. That's why it's there and why you should use it. See you in the next one.